Hello, my name is Natalie, and I'm one of the engineers that helps build Google Web Designer. And in this video, we're going to do a walkthrough of how to create animations using the Advanced Mode timeline. The timeline panel is located at the bottom of the workspace by default. This is actually one of two timeline tools that we have, the other one being the Quick Mode timeline. Many files will open by default in Quick Mode, and you can toggle between them by pressing this button in the top right-hand corner. So this is Quick Mode, and this is the Advanced Mode. We have a separate tutorial covering Quick Mode, and in this one we'll just focus on Advanced Mode, which is the more complex but also the more powerful of the two tools. As a tutorial exercise, I've got this short little animated ad, which has a sliding image, two text boxes that fade in and out, and a logo that appears at the end. And in this video, we'll step through how we can build this ad in Google Web Designer. So let's take care of that sliding image animation first. The first step would be to drag it on stage and position it the way that we want it to appear at the beginning of the animation, so right around there. And later on, we'll have it slide over like so. And you can see that this little track appeared in the timeline. This is a timeline layer, and this is the UI in which we'll lay out the animation for this object over time. The basic idea behind creating animations is we're going to be defining keyframes, which are waypoints in time where an element has specific property values, and then defining how and how long a transition between those values. So to make this image slide, we'll make several keyframes. We want it to hold in place for about a second, so I'll place the keyframe at 1 second by right-clicking and selecting Insert Keyframe. Then one more half a second later. And then at this keyframe, I'm going to slide the image over to where I want it to be at this point in time. Then I want this image to hold in place for another second. And then finally, a half a second later, I want it to slide out of view completely. So now if we drag the playhead, you can scrub the timeline and get a preview for your animation. And you can also press the play button in the left-hand corner here to get a preview right on stage. And that looks good. And the next thing, we saw in the finished piece that the image actually fades in at the very beginning, in addition to sliding over later. So let's do that fade animation next. I'm going to select all the keyframes using the Marquee tool and slide it over to make room for the fade in at the very end, and insert a new keyframe at time zero. And at this keyframe, we'd like for the element's opacity to be zero. And at all the other keyframes, we'd like for it to be at 100%. Next, let's add the text. So as we saw, there were two text boxes, and they faded in one after the other as the image slides. So let's create the first text box. So the first text box should fade in, then stay in place over this period here, and then fade out as the image slides. The first thing to do would be to zero out the opacity on this box, because that's the starting state. Then we can create a keyframe at half a second, set the opacity to 100%. At a second and a half, we want it to still be 100%, and then at 2 seconds, we want it to be 0% again. So one thing you can do is just insert a keyframe, much like we've done before, but you can also take advantage of keyframe duplication. If you hold Alt, you can create a clone of a keyframe and drag it to a different time. So this can save you some time with some animations. And let's add the last one where the text box fades out completely. We can take a preview now. Perfect. Okay. And the second text box is actually pretty much identical to the first text box, just the text is different, and it comes in after the first one's faded out. So I'm going to save myself a little bit of time and just duplicate this layer together with the animation by right-clicking it, selecting Duplicate Layer. And then once again, I can use the Marquee selection to select all the keyframes and move them to where this animation should be. I'm going to adjust these keyframes where the first text box fades out and the second one fades in so they don't crossfade. And anytime your keyframes get this close together, you can use the zoom slider to get a more high-res view of your animation. So now let's also update the text. So right now I have these two text boxes, one on top of the other. So if I click here right now, I might accidentally edit the top one. So I'm going to go ahead and lock it so that I don't accidentally activate it. And this will let me edit the one underneath. So now our animation is pretty much done. Let's take a closer look at what's going on between the keyframes. You can see that between every pair of keyframes it says linear. This refers to the CSS easing function, which is used to compute intermediate values between every pair of keyframes. So linear means that the values change at a constant rate. We have some other options here. If you right-click, you'll see that you have available all the standard easing functions specified in the CSS spec. So particularly for this transition where the image slides from one half to the next, it can be good to choose a different easing function such as ease in out, in which the motion accelerates a little bit and then decelerates before coming to rest, which simulates real world motion a little bit more closely. So I'm going to limit my preview area by dragging these yellow handles just to this transition here, and I'm going to set preview on loop and run the preview just over this area so I can debug that transition. And that looks good. And one other thing we can do is, rather than using one of the predefined functions, we can also create our own. So if you right-click and select Easing Options, you can customize this Bezier curve to be anything that you like and save out a custom preset and click OK to apply it. So that just about wraps up this tutorial. For those interested, we have some other tutorials going more in depth on other animation-related subjects. And that's it for now, and thanks for watching.